Like, I would like to share my unique journey of how I came into and how I decided into civil services. Like, I have two living inspirations at home. One, my mother, who's an advocate, and my father, who has a school for himself. And these two people at home were those two self-made people whose journey I've been watching. Everybody asks me now, who was your inspiration? And I couldn't have a better inspiration than these two people who were completely self-made and all by themselves. I can see an epitome of courage in my mother every single day fighting in the courtrooms. I heard from my father that she went to the court even the next day, it was going to be her delivery, and she went to the court even the day before. And my father, he is the epitome of humility I see. He has done his MSc, MBA, and then he has been like trying to search for passion of his own. And then now he has a school of his own, and my mom jokes on him every day saying, "No, ni kootur ni kuda inta chadvichukoled," how much amount of effort you put on your students. I see how much amount of dedication he puts towards like giving affordable and very quality education to his students. I couldn't have more better inspiration than them. And now coming to me on how I got into civil services, I had my mother always telling me that if you just do the work which is assigned to you as a civil servant, you can help really a lot number of people. At that point of time when I was young, I used to think, okay, mommy, alane cheptundi, okay, ankunne dani. But then eventually when I started studying, and then they'd never rubbed on civil services onto me. They wanted me to pursue what I want in life. So I was interested in maths and sciences, so eventually IIT happened. But after going there, I've done a lot of internships in Bombay, IISc, Bangalore. And then I've gone to the US in my third year. That is where I was doing a research internship in transportation engineering. And that was that point of time where I had to decide, am I going into research? Am I going into civil services? Or am I going to take a job? Then I asked my mother for a suggestion. The only thing she told me is, I am definitely sure that you'll do good in whatever you take up, but analyze the impact you would create with the amount of knowledge you have. Then I just used to think upon this same line. Then what I realized was, had I been a researcher in the US, I would be serving some other country in those four walls of the room, and probably not contributing as much as I would be doing currently. So I think she is the vision behind my success today. And after this is my personal journey. And however, my civil services journey has been a little difficult. After my graduation, I was working for Hindustan Petroleum. And then I gave my first two attempts, prelims. I couldn't clear prelims in my first two attempts. And then I took a very strong call to resign from my job. And then I said, this time I'll give it a very serious thought. And then the two failures were not easy. They were pretty difficult. There was a time where I was doubting myself. Am I really worth the exam and all? And at that point of time, people around me showed more confidence in me than I myself had. So I think that confidence in their confidence in me kind of lifted me up. And then this time mains, and then interview happened, and then I secured 112 this year. However, I don't think this is going to end. I'll try my best to get a better rank next year. And I think this is how the persistence which we need at that point of time when we face failures is the next important thing I would like to highlight. And the third thing is, until I heard many journeys here, everybody had a very unique journey. Few people had the humility to actually tell what they have been through, like actually bring out in a very honest manner of what their ambitions or motivations behind civil services have been. And inspirations right in front of me tell how resilient we should be. I think I'm going to take a lot of lessons from this very event. And thank you so much, sir, for actually organizing this. So I think everybody has their own journey. Instead of judging on the basis of just how toppers are working or how somebody else is working, we need to define our own path, assess our strengths and weaknesses, and accordingly plan our journey. And if UPSC doesn't work out, I'm sure the process teaches us a lot of things which we can eventually implement in life and become very big people at any field we take up. So I think this is all I would like to speak today, and thank you so much for giving me the opportunity.